Hari Om. We are so fortunate to be sitting today with Acharya Shaila Jamma Nadkarni of Chinmaya Mission Orlando. And Shaila Jamma had the fortune of her life to meet Gurudev in the early 1980s. And we are fortunate to be able to sit here with her and ask some questions and hear her stories about Gurudev and her spiritual journey. So welcome, Shaila Jamma. Thank you.
Thank you, Vilasini ji. I have to say one line that I am so privileged that Vilasini ji is with me taking this interview, and that blessing is showering upon me from Gurudev. Hari Om.
Shaila Jamma, I think we love to hear how you came to Chinmaya Mission. How did you meet Gurudev?
I came to meet Gurudev through one of the great souls. Her name is Pavitra ji. And I remember distinctly, Pavitra ji was invited in Orlando to give some lectures. And me and my husband and two little boys, we went to hear her lecture. And it was in a small church. We were a little late. We sat on the back side, back benches. And the sentence which is ringing in my ear even today is that she was talking about how a personality opens up as from a bud state to a total flowering state, becomes a blooming flower, and the personality's fragrance of all the beauty and quality spread out and wafted around the universe. And that sentence made something change in my heart. And after the lecture, I told my husband, let us meet the Brahmacharini. We met her and I asked her, where can I hear this beautiful talks again? And she said, there is a old master from Himalayas who visits United States in summer. He's coming to Pittsburgh for a camp, and you should come with family there and see him. And that was my beginning to enter into the mission.
Oh my goodness. And then when did you actually meet Gurudev?
My first darshan of Gurudev was when we went to Pittsburgh. We were sitting in a huge hall. Children were in Bal Vihar, me and my husband were sitting in a huge hall. I was sitting right in the front and waiting for Swami Chinmayananda to enter the hall, waiting very eagerly. And suddenly I started hearing Mano Buddhi Ahankara. And my feelings came in my heart that I have come home. Something very familiar, which I had never heard, stirred my heart. And after a few minutes, I saw on the left side a tall, thin figure entering, a saint entering and walking very straight. And as I was raised in a mission school, I felt like, oh, Jesus is walking through. And behind him, the Pittsburgh temple priest was walking, putting flowers behind him as he was walking, chanting Purusha Suktam. And that vision never came out of my heart. And then Gurudev came to the stage and sat, and that was my first darshan of Gurudev.
Did you ever host Gurudev?
I had a chance, we had a chance as a family, all Chinmaya Mission family, to host Gurudev. First, he came to Orlando when we bought a small property, a small house, which was named Tapovanam, and a 5-acre land behind which Hindu temple was going to come. And I remember I was in Canada with my son and my husband, and Gurudev's Yajna was going on. And one of the Bhiksha places, I took that picture before we bought it, and I showed it to Gurudev, and I said, three or four of us want to, Swamiji, start a small center please bless us. So Gurudev saw that picture and asked me to come near him, and he told in my ear, he whispered in my ears, my dear, why you want to do all this? And I was perplexed. I didn't understand what he's saying. And afterwards, Gurudev actually told me, anyway, you are going to do it. So from today, do everything, but remember, you are not doing anything. And I came and told my husband that night that this is what he said. And my husband said, Shaila, you have got a Guru Mantra now. And I realized after several years that indeed that was a great Mahavakya uttered in my ear by a greatest Himalayan master. And that after that, we came back to Orlando. We bought the property, four of us. Three friends, me and Shyam, and then we started our activities according to Gurudev's instructions.
Oh my.
So the first time Gurudev came to that property was the first day when we finished painting in the night. He arrived from islands from Bahamas about 5 hours late his plane was.
Mm-hmm.
So when Gurudev came, we all were there, Chinmaya Mission family, small family, about 50 people and children. We received him, and his first thing was, we have lots of trees there and beautiful. Orlando is tropical. So as he was entering the doors, he said, there is Shiva outside and Krishna inside.
Oh.
I remember that. And then he sat, he had a little small snack and tea. And then he told me he wants to go to our house. And there was very little time left between Gurudev's arrival and his next flight. Shyam said, Swamiji, time is very little. We have to go straight to the airport. So my son was sitting there, 16-year-old Siddhartha. And Gurudev said, Siddhartha, you take me to your house. And it so happened that Swamiji came. He drove very fast. And as we all know, Gurudev was... when Gurudev came to our house, some devotees came. He went around and he went to my prayer room, and then he said, now let's go back to airport. So we took him back. That was Gurudev's first coming to Orlando and in our house. Now there was another time when we had a chance to host Gurudev with the entire, I will say, international Chinmaya family, which was a greatest privilege. But the highest point was Sri Gurudev coming to Orlando. He was in an international camp that year, and my father and mother were visiting me at that time. So as usually, I loved to run to the camps whenever Swamiji came. That year I could not go. My father had a stroke, and I was with my parents at home in Orlando. And Sri Swamiji's camp started, so my husband took both the boys to the international camp. And there they met Gurudev, and at the end he did tell my husband that, look, I'm coming to Orlando for one night. On my way. So when they came back, my younger son told me that mom, he is coming. And I said, who is coming? And he said, Gurudev is coming, and he said he will stay one night. In my entire life up to that time, I wanted Swamiji to come and stay with us, but I had no courage to write him any letters or ask him. So that wish was fulfilled by him as if he knew, and he was supposed to go and rest somewhere as his health was not permitting him to do extra camps at that time. So the doctors had advised to go and rest. So Swamiji, and in fact just before Swamiji, Vilasniji came to my house. We prepared the room and Swamiji arrived. Gurudev arrived with many devotees before him, started coming to my house from Los Angeles and from California. And I asked them, I said, you know, how do you know that you are supposed to be here? And they said, oh, Gurudev told us in the camp, I'm going to that doctor's house in Orlando. Just come there, I'll see you there. And after that, Gurudev came. He had his lunch, he rested. And in the afternoon, Vilasniji called me that he's calling. So I went there in his room and he told me that, look, I want you to call your associate and take 10 days off. I'm going to stay here for 10 days. And so first I didn't understand. And also he added one line that, I don't know what you have done, but I am going to stay with you for 10 days. And that was the, I did not even think. I went and called my American associate. Usually it takes 2 months for us to take a leave between the practice, seeing patients. So I told him I have to take 10 days off from today. And he said, you can take 1 month off. He totally was prepared for me to go off. And it was like a magic wand of Gurudev started moving. And now I can see the entire Leela of Lord Krishna was unfolding in front of my whole eyes. Shri Krishna unfolding early morning, getting up, giving his tea. About 100 people started coming from Australia. Doctors came from India. CCMT directors, one or two came from India, Hyderabad, the Vidyalaya's Dean, Swami Dhiranand, one of the Swamiji's father came, and all started coming together as if everybody knew that this is the place where Shri Krishna is going to be. And nothing can stop anybody, and everybody was ecstatic in a different mood, like dancing in a different mood. Mm-hmm. And those 10 days, Swamiji was supposed to take a total rest, not speak. So there was no yajna, no camp. But every morning at about 3:45, his door would open. He would be for me it was Pitambara. He would be Bhasma Vibhuti, and it was darshan of Lord Shiva and Krishna in one. I always felt that Lord Shiva and Krishna in one picture I have not seen, but I saw him. And I even told my husband and some of my friends that I never saw Shri Krishna in an old, he never is pictured as an old, when he got old, he probably never got old. But I said, you know, in Gurudev, I saw a total darshan of Lord Shiva and Krishna. And from morning to evening, he used to come out for some time, sit breakfast, have breakfast with many people, laugh, talk very softly, and then he became very silent. He used to sit in a chair. About 100 people from outside and devotees from Orlando used to gather, and we had asked everybody to be silent, and that was our moment with him. And his instruction to my husband every day morning, my husband actually had to go to work. So he came and told Gurudev every day in the morning after breakfast, Swamiji, I have to go to work. Gurudev said, doctor, go to work, but remember, meditate on unborn mind. That was the instructions to my husband. Mm-hmm. He is very introverted. He was very, he's a very meditative, quiet, soft, gentle personality. So Gurudev's instructions, and that was for all of us, I think, but he told him every day. And then people were gently massaging his feet. Soft bhajans went on after the silence. And then he would go to his room. And evening also, he would come out. In the afternoon, Gurudev would watch after lunch and sometimes before lunch. Olympic Games, the recordings were done with the teenagers, with the chicks, and just laugh with them and give them one or two sentence instructions. And this was the entire Leela of Lord Krishna. People coming, Swamis coming, Brahmacharinis, Brahmacharis coming, board of directors coming, all of the mission internationally coming and having his darshan. And this experience is it cannot be explained. It's a little transcendental type of experience, as if I felt after he left that my feet came down to ground. And I said, Shyam, what happened? And truly I felt that I was above the ground on the air for 10 days. Truly, mm-hmm. There was nothing in my heart. I think none of us had anything in our hearts, no questions, nothing, just being with Krishna. That was the experience.
Amma, did you ever travel with Gurudev in the United States?
Yes, Vilasini ji. I had a blessing or privilege to travel with Gurudev in the United States when he was making, was invited in different major universities such as Princeton. He was invited in United Nations to give a lecture.
Oh, in 1992.
Mm-hmm. And it so happened that I always felt that I'm not a Brahmacharini and I will never be with him or traveling with him or taking care of him. But that wish was fulfilled by Gurudev. And I distinctly remember Swamiji, Guruji asking us in Krishnalaya actually, early morning, that there is a Brahmacharini who is not feeling well. So, Dr. Shyam, can you travel with him? And my husband was very busy at that time and he said he will not be able to. So, Guruji asked me, and I would like to even give a small incidence as to how our Gurudev's greatness is, how he is God himself. We started from Krishnalaya at about 3:30, quarter to 4, which was his usual time, in the car. We were supposed to go one time to Los Angeles from there and then get the plane. This incidence was just a car travel with him. And I was sitting on the back seat. A person was driving, Gurudev was sitting in the front. And as you know, in Krishnalaya, if you have gone, those mountains and valleys, and it's such a beautiful scene. So as we went, at about 4:30, quarter to 5, redness started coming up, and by 5:30 a.m. mm-hmm. the red the quite a bit of ahead of sun light started coming up. Mm-hmm. And at that time sun just started peeking up behind the mountain, and Gurudev turned around and told me, hey, look, my interior decorator is at work. So I was, take every sentence of his, every breath of his, I cannot, you know. But so we reached the Los Angeles, and that was, and several other
or
times.
San Francisco, maybe?
From, no, actually from San Francisco to, I think, from Krishnalaya to one of the, not Los Angeles, sorry, to San Francisco.
Okay.
And we actually, there were many incidences, even traveling with him in the car. But one more incident, me and my friend, this travel is in car, we in United States, she was actually driving. And she, I was driving, she was sitting on the back, and she had a question, two questions she had, and which I got the teachings. I was very lucky that my friends were asking this. She asked Swamiji that, Swamiji, can you give me a mantra? And Gurudev said, hey, I forgot to take mantra from my guru. So both of us were very young, and we said, what? And then he said, then he loudly told her, which was for me also, that what I'm teaching in the evening, in the Yajna, Gita, even 1/4 of a line, if you follow, that is my mantra. Mm-hmm. And take that and follow those instructions in your entire life. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That was one instruction. The other one, she had said, which is for everyone, I want to give this, is that she asked, this was a very personal question, is that, Swamiji, there is somebody I absolutely don't like. Mm-hmm. And how do I deal with that person? Mm-hmm. Absolutely, when that person comes in front of me, I just cannot stand. Gurudev said, my dear, it's very easy. He was standing, actually, we just entered the house, this question was asked, he was going to rest, and he said, whenever you see that person, go to the heart center and visualize your Ishta Devata smiling at you. Mm. And he said, you can never hate that person after that.
Oh my.
So I thought that was a very, very precious moment. We just came out of the car. The other time when I got the chance to travel with him to big universities, one is Princeton, I remember distinctly. His lecture was, there were, the whole hall was filled up with the students. He got a standing ovation. He was just, you know, I don't have to say much about the, but the students were taken up, so many students were flocking around him after the lecture that I was amazed. And the other one I saw was in United Nations. There also everybody stood up, and that message was also beyond. So United Nations, when we were going, a personal small incidents, just the teaching for us, we were on the very, in one of the big hotels in the, Gurudev was in a very top floor. And when we were coming back, I was supposed to take his shawl. It was cold outside, and I forgot to take the shawl. I took the bag and I forgot to take the shawl. We came down to the stairs, and I suddenly realized when we came out of the elevator that the shawl is not there. So I said, Swamiji, I'm going to get a shawl. He said, only one chance. To get things only. So he said, there is no need. Number one thing is, he was beyond bodily, even though you are beyond heat and cold. That was my mistake. But what he taught me is, once you got to be perfect. In many times I learned the lesson that mistakes can be done, but you got to be, your awareness has to be total, not just a little here and little there. And then the person who was supposed to take us to United Nations was late, so Gurudev asked me to get the taxi, and I got the taxi. And in that person, as soon as we sat, the person came running, and he said, just follow us. So I saw one more thing in a yajna. When he started walking, we were supposed to take him, one devotee and me, through a shortest route to the hall. And we kind of took a little longer route. And I said, Swamiji, we will have to turn around to go to the hall from this. He didn't even look at me. He said, just follow. And he said, once you start, that was another thing, that no mistake should be done. If he never turned around, he never said, okay, this, that path, just walk the path, that's it. So we just walked, and what the lesson I learned is, even at airports, when he started walking to the plane and we wanted to say goodbye and he should look at us, and he never turned around. It was his way of teaching, that once you start, just start. There is no need of turning around and constantly by and constantly, you know, it's just the straight path, and it's just that all paths reach the same place. And these are the small things which personally I learned. But his glory at the United Nations, I will not be able to explain, with all the diplomats and everybody sitting, and they were awestruck, wonderstruck. I was looking at some of their faces, and it was amazing how he can touch one who has no idea, because Gurudev was not a Hindu, not a Christian, not a Muslim. Gurudev was God. And when God speaks, and I feel that every time I heard him, that I have to say that God spoke with us. God spoke with me, and God spoke with us. None of us can say that I did not hear directly from God. At least I cannot say that. In this Tirunelvelli, the inauguration day, the first day, we were supposed to be in Chinmaya Vidyalaya ground, and it was all the tarp and on the ground, everybody was sitting, 1,000 people were sitting there first day. And we got the news before we left for that that place. There was a small Ganesh temple in the Vidyalaya, and we got a news that Swami Chidananda, the head of Divine Life Society, is visiting, passing through Tirunelvelli. And he came to know that Swami Chinmayananda is here starting the yajna, and he wanted to meet Gurudev. So Gurudev sent the message, I will meet you before inauguration in Ganesh temple. And they both entered in that small Ganesh temple from two sides, and nothing can be explained, because there was no talking. There was just a sweetest and only thing, when they're coming out, Chidananda Swami said, Chinmayananda, let me introduce you in inauguration, because I have to leave after that. And Gurudev showed him the watch and said, you have less than 5 minutes. So we went to the, they both went to the stage, entered the stage, he sat and he told Chidananda Swami to speak up, he said. And Chidananda Swami stood up and he started speaking. And the two lines which I will just tell is that one he said, he was glorifying Gurudev and he said, if you ever have heard Vedanta, but majority have not seen Vedanta walking. Chinmayananda Swami is, Vedanta has embodied as Chinmayananda Swami. And he is speaking through Chinmayananda Swami. So embodied Vedanta is Chinmaya. So this Chidananda Swami's after introduction, Gurudev started showing him the watch. Time is up. Because he was glorifying. So after that, every day Swamiji gave 1.5 hours of lecture on Bhagavad Gita on the grounds. People were sitting on the ground on the tarp and not a single person was moving. And this was his aura and this was his effect on from the very beginning. I heard when he was very young to up to the last breath, Gurudev had taught this word of God and spread the word of God in a fashion that I have not encountered it, anybody doing that way. So they said he was embodied Vivekananda Swami also. Mm-hmm. So that came true.
You have said that you've seen him when he was ill, with a toothache and still speaking and
yes.
So many experiences. Can you share about that?
Sure. I had few chances to see Gurudev in situations where one of my personal encounter was that when he came to Orlando in one of the bhiksha place, he had a little difficulty in chewing. So after the bhiksha, Gurudev called me and said, is there a dentist? And I happened to have a dentist next to me standing. So I said, yes, Swamiji. And we made an appointment next day and we went to the dentist who did the work on him. And as we know that there were one or two teeth who the dentist was working on, and as we know that we have to do a lot of local anesthesia and there was a lot of work going on, it was 2 days work. And the dentist said that there will be tremendous numbness and otherwise you will have a lot of pain. Either way, you will have to tell me because we will have to cancel your lecture tonight. And as soon as he said, Gurudev started laughing so much and he said, my dear, that is my decision about lecture. You just do your work.
That was Dr. Kathuria, right?
Yes, Dr. Kathuria.
Kathuria.
And he worked on Gurudev. And I remember that distinctly, I was standing there, Dr. Kathuria was giving him the Novocaine and numbing his areas on both sides of his jaw. And as usual, the dentists, when they numb you, even you cannot talk, they ask the questions. He asked him, Swamiji, when do you take vacation? And Swamiji started laughing. He said, my whole life is a vacation, my dear. He said, what is vacation? And then he got the work done and we were supposed to come the next day. And when we stood up, he stood up from the dental chair. The doctor asked him to, are you still going to give lecture? And he said, of course, but just don't see how I talk. I will say shaw, shoo, shaw. So he started making faces, making us laugh. And by the time doctor said your Novocaine is going to wear off and you will have to take lots of pain medication because you have two sides done. And Gurudev said, I will decide. We went straight to the Yajna hall. The time was up to the point and not even 1 minute late. They were ready with his tea outside room. One person said, Swamiji, you have to drink tea. And Swamiji did not even look at him. He straight went to the stage and gave 1.5 hour of Gita lecture, roaring, dynamic, as a roaring lion in the Vedanta forest. So I just felt like, you just go behind the lion. The roaring will be in your ears. It was beyond imagination for me as anybody. When Novocaine wears off, I had the experience personal how it hurts. And without taking any pain medication, any other medication, 1.5 hour to talk fluently and roaringly, you think anybody but Krishna will talk about Gita.
Amma, I think you were with Gurudev in San Diego in the hospital. Do you have memories of that time?
Yeah, sure.
In San Diego, when I reached there, when I heard that Gurudev is hospitalized, when Gurudev was hospitalized, I told my husband I have to go and have his darshan. So I went, and as I went there, many devotees were sitting in the waiting room. Guruji also came, and we were all sitting, the directors and all, and we were all with heavy heart. And Gurudev was in the intensive care unit, and I had a chance to have a darshan of him. Some of us devotees came and sat back again. That night it was decided that he is supposed to be transferred to the other hospital, a Sharp hospital, for further treatment. And then he went to Sharp hospital, and then we were all chanting in the waiting room. All devotees were heavy hearted. We couldn't even much talk. We somehow had some little dinner here and there, and our hearts were just totally pulled down. And in the meanwhile, the spirits were getting pulled down, and it was just an experience of our lifetime. And I, that night, somehow got to sleep in the waiting room. Everybody had gone, and I was told that I need to go, and I said I will go in a little while, but I sneaked out. I slept there. And that night, about 3:30, quarter to 4, the bell rang, and at that time, the phones were actually on the walls. They're mounted. We did not have mobiles or cell phones, or we did not have any other phones. So in the waiting room, I got up. I was physically tired, mentally exhausted. So many phone calls were coming. So I got up, I got the phone, and I said hello. And from the other side, this voice came. This is Swami Chidananda. And I suddenly realized, you know, this is the Swami which I saw in Tirunelveli. And I said, Swamiji, and he said, how is Swami Chinmayananda? And I told him immediately, I said, Swamiji is very critical. And he said, Guru is never critical. And do not use word, there is no critical. That quote unquote, when I heard from Swami Chidananda's mouth, my heart was as if a big stone was laid on it, and it suddenly got lifted, and my heart became like a butterfly, started dancing all around, and I realized that Swamiji, Gurudev is not critical. He's beyond body consciousness, and what am I thinking about? Swami Chidananda also said one more line, and that is quote unquote, is that whoever had a glimpse of Swami Chinmayananda have total Ishwar Darshan in their life. And unquote. And then at the end he told me, take your shoes off, go to the third floor and bask in the presence of Brahman. He told me, bask in the presence of Brahman. And I just cannot explain what that meant to me at the time. And I did, he said, I'm coming at 10:30 to visit Swami Chinmayananda, and I will be there in San Diego. Hari Om. And after he hung up, I went to the third floor, intensive care, where Gurudev was with a nurse there. I entered the room, and the nurse was a male nurse who asked me, who is this person? Who is this personality? And I said, he's a great saint from India. And I said, why you are asking? And he said, you know, we nurses all want to take care of him. Sometimes there is an argument between us. And I got this privilege tonight because this room is wafting with fragrance. The nurse told me that, you know, most of the patients are different in intensive care. This is a very special patient, and I had this blessing. And all these experiences for me, I stood in stunned silence there. This was so stunning, which I cannot explain. Gurudev looked like a Bhishma Pitama with all the tubes coming out of him. And I realized this body is not Gurudev. I realized he's Brahman. And I am under the sunshine of the Brahman, feeling that warmth and glow and light and basking in it. And I just felt that silent moment, tremendous moment of my life. And that is the highest point of my life. And then I came down and I shared with some devotees who started trickling down. Everybody was chanting Om Namah Shivaya Trayambakam Japa Mrityunjaya Mahamantra. And then I had to leave early. Chidananda Swami came, and there are some other experiences. But basically, I want to share this experience that for all of us, not for me, for all of us who are Gurudev's disciples, devotees, Gurudev's followers, Gurudev's glimpses, where Gurudev's even name they have heard for 1 second, they are all had total Ishwar Darshan, we all. And we are not only were basking in the presence of Brahman at that time, but as if we are basking in the presence of Brahman now. And I feel that continuously, as if he is holding my hand and guiding me through. He knows my heart, he guides me through, he is my guru. And I will say at the end that all of us, for me for sure, but I feel for all of us of one as devotees, and as this one spirit, we have spoken with God, we have lived with God, and we have been with God, so we can never say, I never saw God. Hari Om Tat Sat, Jai Gurudev, Jai Jai Jagadishwar.